no one was found worthy to open the scroll or to look into it. Then one of the elders said to me, "Do not weep. See, the Lion of the tribe of Judah, the root of David, has conquered, so that he can open the scroll and its seven seals." Then I saw between the throne and the four living creatures, and among the elders, a lamb, standing as if it had been slaughtered, having seven horns and seven eyes, which are the seven spirits of God sent out into all the earth. He went and took the scroll from the right hand of the one who was seated on the throne. When he had taken the scroll, the four living creatures and the 24 elders fell before the Lamb, each holding a harp and golden bowls full of incense, which are the prayers of the saints. They sing a new song. "You are worthy to take the scroll and to open its seals. For you were slaughtered, and by your blood you ransomed for God saints from every tribe and language and people and nation. You have made them to be a kingdom and priests serving our God, and they will reign on earth." Then I looked, and I heard the voice of many angels surrounding the throne and the living creatures and the elders. They numbered myriads of myriads and thousands of thousands, singing with full voice, "Worthy is the Lamb who was slaughtered to receive power and wealth and wisdom and might and honor and glory and blessing." Then I heard every creature in heaven and on earth and under the earth and in the sea, and all that is in them, singing, "To the one seated on the throne and to the Lamb, be blessing and honor and glory and might forever and ever." And the four living creatures said, "Amen." And the elders fell down and worshipped. Here ended the message.
communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Thank you. governed by all thy wisdom, O Lord, all that my soul may always speak, serving thee as thou hast will, and not as I may choose. Do not punish me, I beseech thee, by granting that which I wish you ask, if it offends thy love, which would always live in me. Let me die to myself, that so I may serve thee. Let me live to thee, who in thyself art the true life. Amen. We humbly beseech thee, by goodness, O Lord, to comfort and succour all them who in this transitory life are in trouble, sorrow, need, sickness, or any other adversity. Help us to minister to them by strength and consolation, and so endow us with the grace of sympathy and compassion, that we may bring to them both help and healing. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Let your mercy and blessing, O Lord of Lords, rest upon our land and our nation, upon all the powers which you have ordained over us, our Queen and those in authority under her, the ministers of state and the great councils of the nation, that we may lead a quiet and peaceable life in all godliness and honesty. All the hearts of our people in your faith and fear, rebuke the power of unbelief and superstition, and preserve to us your pure word in its liberty and glory, even to the end of our days. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. O God, by whom the meek are guided in judgment, and light rises up in darkness for body, give us in all our doubts and uncertainties the grace to ask what thou wouldst have us to do, that the spirit of wisdom may save us from all false choices, and that in thy light we may see light, and in thy straight path may not stumble. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Vouchsafe, O Lord, to prosper with your blessing the work of all universities, colleges, and schools at this time, that they who serve you therein as teachers or learners may set your holy will ever before, and be led to the knowledge of your truth, so that both church and world may benefit from their studies, and they themselves become worthy partakers of eternal life. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, Creator, in these days of coronavirus, the storm has assaulted us. Greenness has enveloped, and mists around it are going out and are coming in. Now again, let thy glory come. Thy light lift up our hearts to thee, and night fall once again in peace. Through mist and storm, all sunshine and virus, the crops have ripened here, and the vines have grown. Thy constant care in all and everywhere is manifest, and so we